In the footy, Big Mal's Roosters were big winners on Friday, but
yes.
He's not the PM anymore.
No,
he's
Scott
not. Morrison is.
He is, and a fella just walked into the studio, and I said, "G'day, how you doing?" He said, "Oh, I've been pretty busy." I said, "Oh, what are you doing?" He said, "Running the country." Of course, the new Prime Minister, Scott Morrison, first time on the Grill Team. Welcome.
Thanks, Matty.
Hey. How are you holding up? How's things? Scott?
Mate, great. Look, it's a great privilege, and it's a humbling experience, as people would expect it to be. But now you just roll your sleeves up and you just get on with it. I mean, the events of the last 3 weeks were pretty not expected, let's just say that, to put it calmly. But, you know, when you're in those situations, you've been involved in sport across your life. You just have to step up, and that's what I've been doing.
You're... carry a lot of responsibility, Prime Minister, because I think at the moment, and you'd be acutely aware of how disenchanted people are with politics.
Mm.
All the switching and the changing. And
yeah.
What do you stand for? What are you going to give us today?
Fair go for those who have a go.
And I'll just say this before you start. Because, you know, it's really funny because we get some of the blokes in here. We've had Mr. Abbott. We've had Bill Shorten. And it's funny. There's such and Bill Shorten, he was one that really surprised me when he came in, because when the camera turns on, it looks like a bit of a pumpkin. But when he came in, you talk to him.
Yeah.
He's a really good bloke, like a really good fella. And I go, where's that bloke? You know, where's that bloke when the camera goes on?
Mm.
So a lot of people are listening at the moment. At the moment, you're in your honeymoon period.
Mm.
So what do you stand for? What are you going to...
It's an interesting honeymoon period, I've got to tell you, but that said...
Well, the polls are swung around. The opinion polls are swung around, as they did with Malcolm.
A long way to go. Yeah.
But what do you stand for? What are you going to give us?
Well, what I just said, I want... In Australia, if you have a go, you should get a go. And there's a lot of talk about fairness in this country, and what does it mean? And to me, it doesn't mean everyone gets the same thing. It means that if you really put in, and it doesn't matter what your level of ability is or what opportunity, we want everyone to have the same opportunities. But when you really stump up, then you should be able to get ahead in life. Now, I'm a mortgage belt liberal. I've got a mortgage like everyone else. I've got two young kids, 9 and 11, going to school. And that's the center of my life, is my family. And the values that come out of being a dad, the values that come of just, living a life in the suburbs of Sydney, and that's how I grew up as well. They're the values and beliefs that I think you've got to take into the job, because that's what everyone else is dealing with. So, look, our economy is actually going much better than it has for some years, but I know not everybody feels that. And I've got the plans to make sure that we can get that out to everybody, that those economic benefits, so they can do better on their mortgage, they can do better on their power prices, they can do better with the other bills, and that they know when they go and put the extra effort in, that, they'll pay less tax as a result, and they'll be able to get ahead and not feel like they're just smashing their head against the wall.
Could you give us an example? So the blokes out there working on the road at the moment.
Yeah, sure. The guys who are turning up are already on site now. They're paying less tax because of what I've done in terms of taxes on small and medium-sized businesses. They're paying less tax on the utes that they've bought. Those who are earning every dollar every day now, the tax plan I had put through the parliament means we're getting rid of a whole threshold in the tax system. No one will pay under the tax plan I've already had legislated into the future any more than 32.5% in tax on their marginal rate, other than 6% of the population. So 94%. No more than 32.5 cents in the dollar in tax.
How do you make up that tax?
How do I make it up?
How do you make that up? There's going to, if you're pulling back at one side, there's got to be...
Yeah, well, this is how it works. If you grow the economy, which is what we've been doing, the economy is now growing at 3.4%, faster than the US, faster than the UK, faster than Japan, faster than Germany, all of these countries. Now, we've done through that through a lot of hard work. If you grow the economy, then there's more for everybody. If you do things which hurt the economy, like put taxes up on it and have stupid regulations, and you don't support small business, then the economy gets smaller. And so we're for a bigger economy, which means bigger opportunities for everybody and that everyone gets a fair go.
PM, it's good to hear that, because like you say, the last 3 weeks has been an absolute disaster, for everyone, because we want government to be out there working for us and stuff. And there was days there where you thought, was anyone actually doing anything? So to hear some positivity like that is great. So I think that's probably the hardest thing for you over the next however long before you call an election. will you have enough time to be able to get that across to all of us? Because there's some, like Maddie said, people at the moment are sort of flipping and flopping a little bit, and that Wagga result for the New South Wales Liberal government obviously wasn't a good one. So do you think you have enough time to be able to get that across and let people know that, you know, you're a safe pair of hands taking us forward?
Yeah, well, look, I've been part of the government for the last 5 years. I was there when we stopped the boats and was critical and central to that. I was there in social services when we've now got that level of people being dependent on welfare of a working age to the lowest level in 25 years. I've been there as the treasurer as we've got the budget, you know, getting it close back to balance and the economy's been improving and we've been getting taxes down. So, you know, we've got a track record. But look, people are giving me a go and I thank them for that. They are giving me a go and they understand that the events of a few weeks ago were just completely mystifying, but they're also prepared to give me a go. And the election's next year. So there's time, I think, for people just to get to know me. I'm just going to be myself. I was down in Melbourne last week on the grill team down there in Melbourne. And I agreed with Eddie. I mean, they were going, oh, what's your AFL team? And I said, well, I don't have one. I don't follow the AFL.
Spot on.
And you know, I'm a Shark supporter. That's who I support. And I go along to the games and I enjoy them like I'm sure you guys do if you go to a game of AFL. But, you know, what you're going to get from me is just me.
Wait, you went to school, City Boys High?
Yeah.
What did you want to be when you were at school?
Oh, look, like I think a lot of young people at that time, I was sort of open to a lot of things. I was enjoying hanging out with my mates and, you know, playing footy and I used to row back at school then so I was a bit slimmer than I am now. But I was just looking forward to my future.
What's your biggest vice, Prime Minister?
My biggest vice?
Vice.
I like a beer.
Well, you're a good company here. That's not really a vice.
We said vice. can we ask you, PM, how you felt when Latrell Mitchell just got his hand and flicked the ball out of Luke Lewis's arms when he was about to score for your beloved to make it 18-all against the Chooks.
I know. I
mean, talk us through that moment.
Well, Luke,
for you.
Luke, that would happen to Luke about, you know, once a millennia, I think. And that's, I think, was one of that was the key turning point of the game. I suppose there are a few others. But that was pretty crushing. This is why the Roosters won last week, is they just took their opportunities every time they had one. And look, there are some pretty tough calls we got there, but that's one thing. But then they just went and scored on the next set of six. And that's what you got to do. Yeah. And we didn't do that last week, and the boys know that. And so they'll turn up tonight, and I think with that firmly in mind and very determined. But it's going to be, I think, a classic tonight.
They're a good side, the Roosters, because they've got a halfback in Kronk who holds his nerve under the blowtorch.
Mm.
Are you planning for the blowtorch when it happens? And when you build policy they're not happy with, because this has been the beginning of the end of some prime ministers, when they do something and the majority didn't like it, and they go, oh, and they flip-flop.
Yeah, well, I mean, I've already been through that baptism of fire. I mean, I remember when I was immigration minister and shadow immigration minister, everybody threw everything at me. They all said, oh, you'll never fix this. You'll never be able to do that. You shouldn't do it that way. I mean, there's no short of lots of advice you get in politics from all sorts of quarters, but you got to know what you're about yourself. You got to know what you think's going to work. You got to listen to people. You got to do all that. But at the end of the day, you've got to know what you're about. So I've proved it, I think, on I don't know how many occasions, but even in this job, your skin gets thick quick. in this job, as it has to be. And so I don't shy away from that. I accept that as part of the responsibility. You'll get the sledging, you'll get the praise, and, you know, you just look through all of it. You got to look through the dust.
Mr. Prime Minister, if you wouldn't mind putting your headphones on, we're going to open up the phone lines on 133353 if anyone has a question for you this morning. And we've got a caller on the line. It's Malcolm from Point Piper, I believe. Malcolm, good morning.
Good morning to you. Hello to the grill team and hello to you, ScoMo. Congratulations on becoming the 30th Prime Minister of Australia. I'm calling from Point Piper. I've just flown into the country. I'll be flying out again. But I just wanted to ask you, when you were patting me on the back...
Doesn't sound anything like the Malcolm I know.
He's
had no idea, this guy.
Prime Minister, he's had a hard couple of weeks.
He's chattling someone else, I think. I mean,
Now, before the spill, when you were patting me on the back, ScoMo, did you have a knife in your hand? Because there's one stuck right between my shoulder blades.
Who's this Muppet?
Well, that's pretty rich coming from Fozzie Bear.
At least he's funny.
You blokes work this routine
I'll tell you what,
out.
I'm Statler and Waldorf at the moment. I'm going to sit in.
They're somewhere else. They're down in Melbourne.
So after winning 38 consecutive preferred prime ministers, why did I get kicked out? By the way,
mate, I don't know who you're pretending to be today, but I know who I am.
Okay, good on you. Thank you very much.
Malcolm, thank you for the call. Scott, thank you very much for coming in this morning. It was nice to meet you.
One more thing before we go. Vicks Vapor Rub. The kid in the Vicks Vapor Rub commercials. Was that you back in the day?
That wasn't me. I was in another commercial, right. which thankfully, that's when digital cameras and footage weren't around.
Right.
So I suspect that is log on the cutting room floor from a long time ago.
Someone's hunting that down.
I think they will be. But if someone thought they had it and they thought it was that kid, I was in another one. I was.
Oh right.
Yeah. I'll give him a hint. I was wearing a yellow raincoat.
Oh. Okay.
But a raincoat is something you need in this job too.
I bet, particularly
when you come in here.
Thank you so much for coming in. We didn't have Big Mal, the original Big Mal, ever on the grill team in his time. But like Matty said, we've had all the other prime ministers and deputies. So nice for you to step up and good luck tonight for your Sharkies.
I'm looking forward. It should be a great contest.
Hopefully we'll talk to you again soon.
Yeah, and it's sad we don't have Wade out there tonight. He's my favourite player, Wade.
He's some sort of player.
But I saw him after the game last night and he could tell this was a season engine. Ending injury, but to Gals and to Flano and all the boys tonight, we'll be there rooting you on. Cheers.
If you make the grand final, we'll invite you to our grand final luncheon.
That should be fun. You can get whoever that guy was here as well.
The Grill Team, Triple M Breakfast.